Hello everyone and welcome to the Azure Serverless Conf 2021. Today we will be talking about serverless app with Blazor WebAssembly and Azure Static Web Apps. My name is Jose Javier Colombier and DevExpress and Microsoft MVP, and I'm really happy to be discussing with you about all these amazing technologies that are shaping the future of web development. So if we think about this for a second, this perfect combination of having a Blazor WebAssembly app that runs completely on the client browser and Azure Static Web App that is serving that static content, that HTML, that CSS, that JavaScript, and your asset or your image, and is globally distributed so the content is closer to your users, and using Azure Function in the back end to take care of any processing. I don't want to say that this is infinitely scalable, but you really are going to be able to handle a big amount of users with this combination. So let's see the recipe. The recipe will be a Blazor WebAssembly app, Azure Functions, a class library for shading code between your backend, your Azure Function API, and your Blazor WebAssembly app, an explosive combination GitHub Actions deploying to an Azure Static Web App. That will mean that you will have out of the box every time that you commit to your to any branch that you choose or your master branch. Automatically, a GitHub action will deploy a workflow that it will take care of deploying all your application and your API to an Azure Static Web App. So let's see these three parts separate. First thing is Blazor WebAssembly. To get to the part about why Blazor WebAssembly is amazing, we need to just think for a little bit about how web development is being done for years and years. So you pretty much have a server or a hardware anywhere. It could even be a Raspberry Pi that is running some code. It could be C#, it could be Go, it could be Java, and that's happening on the server. Then you need to run some code on the browser, and that's for years and years has been JavaScript. So, and with frameworks like React, Angular, Vue, or you can even use TypeScript and do some translation, but it has always been a chain that you cannot reuse your current skill. Like we are a .NET job, a .NET developer that we know how to use Visual Studio. We are used to use Nuget, to use our tooling, and we haven't been able to use all that knowledge in the browser. So WebAssembly came to solve all of that. So WebAssembly came to allow us to build interactive web UI with the chart. So that means that everything is running client-side. So WebAssembly is this binary format, is that intermediate language between our code and the browser that the browser completely understands and can run. So theoretically, we could use a complete application without writing just not even one line of JavaScript. The Microsoft team really need, they compile the .NET runtime and the .NET interpreter to WASM, to WebAssembly, so that way it can run all our DLLs, all our code. So think about the possibilities of having, like, we pretty much became almost a full stack developer from in a day. We were used to do all this code, all these validations, all this reading a file. All these APIs are the same one that we are used to implement. Now we can do it in the browser side. Also, it's built on Open Web Standard, so it's the four web standard that the web already adopted. So it's HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and WebAssembly. That means there is no plugin. A lot of people are kind of confused and they think, hey, can this be another silver light? It won't be. This is already adopted for all the modern and major browsers. So unless you have a really old browser older than your car, you shouldn't have any issue whatsoever here. And it has a really, really first class support for JavaScript interop. So JavaScript is something that people love or hate. And I won't get in that discussion, but it has been around for a lot of time. It has a lot of stable libraries, it has a lot of stable solutions, so it's not going anywhere. And we can call JavaScript methods from .NET and .NET methods from JavaScript right away. And if I can recommend the latest ASP.NET community stand-up, they put an example of actually calling JavaScript Blazor components from JavaScript. So the possibilities are amazing. So we could have our React application and be starting to inject or Blazor components. The future is really promising in this regard. So, and the last thing that I want to point out for WebAssembly, and this is one that is really important, is the active community. There is a big amount of developers using it with great results. So that's always a good point to adopt a new technology. Now let's talk a little bit about Azure Function. Azure Function pretty much is a compute on demand. So we're gonna run this processing, this method, this function on the cloud. And it will take care of everything from me. It will take care of the infrastructure. It will take care of scaling up and down, depending meeting the demand. And that will mean that I will have to do less code. I will need less infrastructure. I will save cost because also it only charges for the amount of time that is running. We could be doing a process file of loads. We could be responding to database changes, running a scheduling tag, or building a web API endpoint. It doesn't matter. We are only gonna get charged for the amount of time for the processing that is taking place. It's also highly scalable. So that means that without us having to do anything, Azure Function are already set up to scale up and down depending on demand. That means that if we get a huge amount of requests, a lot of users calling that endpoint, our application will take care of adding a new instance or anything that it needs to do to handle that load. But if less users are calling, are doing the request, so it will drop off all the instances that it doesn't need, and it will fall automatically back to any extra resource that it might not be in use due to the low demand in that moment. So it takes care of all of those for us. With that out of the way, let's focus now on the main topic, Azure Static Web App. This is a great, great solution that I'm really excited about, especially because it takes care of so much plumbing for us. It takes care of all the web hosting for static content like HTML, CSS, JavaScript. And this is, if you think about our Blazor WebAssembly app, is all we need. The only thing that we need is to provide all this to the browser, so the browser take care of all the processing for us, because the code is running natively on the browser. It have support for Azure Functions, so automatically when we deploy our app to a static web app, it takes care, it knows how to handle the Azure Function, it takes care of everything that we need there, and we're good to go. It has first-class GitHub and Azure DevOps integration, so as you will see in the demo shortly, pretty much we just let the static web app know what is the location in our repo for our client, for our rep, for our API, and voila, it puts some workflow through GitHub Actions, and every time that we commit to the branch of our choosing, it does a deploy for us, and it's also globally distributed, so this is really important. So the content, if you, in the traditional way, have a server where you have all your information, so if a client from another region connects, the trip will be longer, but here it will be distributing your assets and to the location closest to your user. So it's actually going to be improving the performance on your application. It has support for free certificates and custom domain. So pretty much, and the great thing is like those free SSL certificates also apply to your custom domains, and it takes care of all the renewal and everything else in between. Custom domains, as we just talked, and this is one of the things that I like the most. It has a staged versions powered by pull request. What does that mean? That when we create a new pull request, it automatically creates a new environment for you where you can click and see the actual app already deployed and see if anything in that pull request break any feature on your application. If that pull request doesn't look good, if anything got altered, you will catch it right away. So it's not only reviewing the code, you can see a version of your application already deployed running for you. And this is in my opinion, one of the great things. So pretty much if you see, you will do a code change, and then GitHub, when you commit with GitHub or Azure DevOps, they will take action and they will start deploying your application and will put everything that you need, the static content and the API ready to go. So let's see it in action. Let's move to Visual Studio then. And we have, if we see this solution, when we have three projects, the WebAssembly app, our function, and the shared class library to reuse the code and have our models or extension helpers, anything that we need to share between the two projects above. So if we check here, we have a WebAssembly app and we are running in Net 5 with our WebAssembly Nougat package, and pretty much let's run it real quick so we can see and have a quick visual of what is the application about. We have a really simple app. It's just one page showing the speaker for the Azure Serverless Conf. Let's give it a second. And if we see here, we have pretty much a few of them. Not all of them are here, but it's an application that you can go and check information from the speaker, the Twitter, their GitHub page. You can also see what the name of his talk is, what his title, and what are his preferred skills, and so on and so on. So nothing crazy, and you can even go and check this repository that it will be hosted here later on. That right now we still haven't published it to GitHub. So with that out of the way, let's see how we did that. So pretty much we have a card component and the index racer. Card component pretty much is that card that we see where we're going to iterate for all the speakers that we have. I include the name, the initials, and all the information that we need. And we have our index racer where we pretty much get that information, and we're getting it here from this JSON file where we are gathering all that information. And this, of course, we're going to move it to the action function. So if we just comment this line, and we comment this one, and it's really interesting here to see that we're calling the API guest speaker. That's because in our Azure function, that's the method that we're calling. This is the name of our Azure function, and pretty much right here we have the same JSON. Only difference is that we are hosting our image instead of locally, as we are doing here, we are hosting it in blob storage. That's it. From there, we deserialize that to a list of a speaker, and we return that result. That's pretty much it. So if we run our function for just a second, you will see the URL that the function is running is this one over here. And we can go to a browser tab and do a get, and you should get all the information that we need. So with that one, we're going to now start both projects at the same time to see that if we go to our index, we change here. The only thing that we need to make sure is that we go to program and we let the builder know to get the base address that is on our app settings development JSON, that it was the same one that the actual function was using. And the idea here is that because when we deploy this app settings development JSON, it won't be deployed to the static Azure web app. So we don't have to worry about with this code, we can run it locally, and also we can deploy it. Now, let's come back here. We know that now it's going to call the endpoint API get a speaker, and if everything goes right, it should display the list of a speaker and all the cards. So let's select multiple start projects. We're gonna run the WebAssembly and the function. And if everything goes right, everything should exactly be the same as it was before. Let's give it a second. And voila, really nice, right? So that actual function right now, we are returning the JSON, but that will be calling a database. That will be calling a blob storage. That will bring in the data for any flow that you implemented as a developer. But the great thing here is that we are ready to couple. So we have our Blazor WebAssembly that it will run on the browser, and we have our Azure function that it will take care of all the processing. So we are in a good place to start doing a deploy to Azure Static Web Apps. So the first thing that we're going to do here is we're going to add this to source control, and we're going to add it to GitHub. And we're going to call it Azure Serverless Conf, and we're going to make it public so you guys have access to this code after the chat, the talk. So let's create and push. And in the meantime, I think that we can start going to our Azure portal and start creating our static web apps. So let's select a static web app and create our first app. Okay, right now we're going to select here a subscription. We're going to create a new resource group. We're going to call it Azure Serverless Conf RG. And I always like, especially when we're doing development and testing, create a new resource group for everything that I need to do. That way, at the end, I just delete that resource group and every resource associated to it will get deleted as well. And then we're gonna select the hosting plan for here, doesn't matter, standard, and West US, that is closest to us. Right here, we're gonna sign in with GitHub, and I'm gonna put it in this site for just a second. I'm gonna authorize to have access to my GitHub, and from there, you will see that we will be able to select organization and select all repositories here. So we're gonna call for Azure Serverless Conf and the master branch. Now, right here, we have a choice, so we can select what is the framework that we're using, because static web apps is not only for Blazor, it can only be for Vue.js, for Angular, for React. So any of all those front-end frameworks, they will be able to host their app here and their processing in Azure Function as well. So we're gonna select Blazor. And right here, we need to tell them what is the location of our client app or API app and what will be the output location. So if we take a look here, our app is in the Azure Serverless Conf folder. This is our WebAssembly app. So let's pretty much make sure that we have the name right. We're gonna copy this. We're gonna come back. This is our location for our client app. And then we're gonna do the same one for the function. So I'm gonna copy this. And we're gonna come back to it. And pretty much that's it. Now, Azure Static Web Apps will know how to deploy or client app and we'll know how to deploy your API. So let's review or create. Okay, what did it fail? We're missing something. Okay, the name of our static web app, we're gonna call it Azure Serverless Conf Speakers. And that's it. Let's review and create. Let's click create. And if you see, it will do it really fast. The deployment of the static web app is almost instantaneous. It's one of the fastest deploy that I have been seeing in Azure. But now if we go to our GitHub, and let's find the latest repo that we have. Now we have some extra folders. We have this GitHub workflows. And if we go to actions, you will see that we have a new GitHub action that is already in progress. So just by doing that, the Azure Static Web App create that for us and it's actually doing a deploy for us right now. Let's give it a second. And by the magic of edition, it's already completed. So let's take a look at what it did here. If we see here and we close here, we can take a look at every action that the GitHub action did for us, like set up the job, build the applications, restore new web package, run the action, build and deploy. And now if we go in build and deploy and we scroll down, we should get the URL of our site. Right here, visit your site at PurpleMoss. And then if we click in there, we should have our application running right away. How cool is that? We only have to commit to GitHub and it took care of everything from us. It took care of deploying this complete application to our static web app. It took care of deploying on Azure Function. It took care of everything that we need to do. Okay, let's continue. One other thing that is really cool here is that we have the free SSL certificate. And in this case, we have a domain that was assigned to us by Azure, but we can here include our own custom domain. And actually all the logic behind renewal of that SSL certificate is taken care for us. So we don't have to do anything there. Another thing is like if we go to the GitHub repository and remember this GitHub workflow folder and we open it, we have right here the YAML that put all the steps that our GitHub action took place. So right here we can see that the jobs build and deployed where we went there and looked for the URL of our application. We also have that it's running on Ubuntu and so on, so on. You can read more about it. So let's do another really cool thing. We talk about that another thing that the static web apps provide for us is a staging environment for every time that we create a pull request. So let's go create a new branch, do any small change, create a pull request and let's see what happens. So now, if we come back to Visual Studio, and then let's create a new branch, and let's call it dev. Let's wait for it to change branches, and then we go to, let's say, our main layout. So right here, we're gonna change, and we're gonna add here, this is in September 2021. Let's save it. Let's commit the changes. I'm gonna call it added month. And let's push it. Got it. So with just that, if we go now, come back to our GitHub repository, we see we have two branches, and we quickly click dev. We have right here the branch that we just created. So let's click pull request, and let's make a new one. Let's go from the dev that we just did this change and create the pull request. And let's put just review. Let's create. So the great thing is, you see, we can merge right away, but what is going to happen is, like, actual static web app include that workflow that it will pretty much redeploy my app in a staging environment, so the person that is reviewing is not only going and checking, okay, let me see what is the commit, what they changed, and so on, so on. What they will do is they will come here to the pull request and actually see the application deployed. They will see a live version of that branch with those changes, and they will make sure that nothing has breaking, that nothing is breaking, that everything is working fine. If everything is good to go, then they can approve and they can merge that branch. So how cool is that, that we can not only review the code, we pretty much have a new deployment, a new live version of our application with everything already in place. So let's give it a little second, and if you see, there will be a new comments here with a new URL, and with that one, we will be able to review it. And again, by the magic of addition, so we saw that it already completed. So now the GitHub action bot, it did a comment here saying, hey, your state site is ready, visit it here. So we can click on it, and it will take us to that new redeploy site. So, and if you see, you have the September 2021, and oh no, it did fail. So it has some errors. So now we can just pretty much click inspect, check the console, and say it's unauthorized, and there is an issue here. So we're not gonna fix it, but this is exactly what we were trying to get. So we did a change. It breaks something, we're gonna see why, and we're gonna review it, we're gonna fix it, and we're gonna make sure that we don't merge to master until we actually have all our checks passed. Let's close this, and let's just briefly recap and think about this. So we have a Blazor WebAssembly app that is running in the browser. So all the resources and all the processing is in the client browser. So we are not paying for that server resources. We have an actual function that we only pay for consumption. So it's consumption on demand, and it's also highly scalable. So it scales up and down. It creates new instance or downgrade instance depending of the demand. So, and we only pay for the processing. We only pay for the amount of time that is running. We have a Azure Static Web Apps that is pretty much just holding all our static content, all our image, all our HTML, all our CSS, all our JavaScript. So what is our actual cost? So we are actually running a serverless app with Blazor WebAssembly, with Azure Function, and Azure Static Web App, and our costs are really low. High scalable solution, high affordable solution. This is an amazing solution that can host thousands, if not millions of users. So coming back to the slide for just a second, I want to leave you with a few resources we have here. And let's quickly open it. Few nice tutorials on how to build a static web app. We also have a more learn module that it will take you to every step that you need to publish the static, your Blazor WebAssembly app to Azure Static Web Apps. And with that one, we finish the talk, but if you have any question, or if you want to just keep the conversation going, please, more than happy to collaborate, to share experience. And thank you for the organizers to Azure Service Conf. And until next time.